This is the first planning meeting of the 7th UK Recovery Walk in Durham. That is about celebrating the achievements of individuals in recovery. And very, very importantly, it acknowledges the work of prevention, treatment and recovery service providers. Now that's a huge part of what we do. We're not just an advocacy organisation. We are acknowledging the work that already exists. So the walk's in its 7th year, and this year it's your chance to deliver it. So this walk will have your name written all over it. Throughout the next 12 months, we will have a planning group every month, and you will put your stamp on it.
I'm Michael. I'm in recovery, just started recovery. 48 hours clean off methadone. I went to the last Manchester walk, and I just wanted to be part of it.
I'm Jeff, I've been in recovery for 2 months, and but truthfully I'm here because the therapist fell out of the cup. I'm really pleased. I'm really pleased I'm here and I'm just there. I'm glad to find out what it's all about.
My name's Nina. I've been in recovery for 3 months. I'm so proud Durham is getting the walk and I'll do anything to help.
I am Simon, I'm in long-term recovery, which means to me I haven't took a drink or a drug for a number of years. Why am I here? I owe the life I live today to Durham Recovery Community. So I would like to pay a bit of that back and carry the message a bit further.
I've got an idea that music can change how you feel. And I think recovering people, especially in early recovery, can learn that you can change how you feel. And one of the earliest things you can find out with is music. Music can actually do what the drugs and alcohol used to do.
My name's Anna, I'm in short-term recovery. That means I haven't used any alcohol or drugs yet for 4 months. And I was at the recovery walk in Manchester, so I came along today to see what this recovery walk's all about and what I can contribute to it.
I'm Scott, I'm 30 days clean from opiates. I'm a keen musician, so I'm on Russ's team, whatever I can do, you know. Very keen to put some music into it if needs be, just happy to do what I can help.
Why am I here today? Really because I was at the walk in Manchester and I just was absolutely blown away and inspired by just the love and the atmosphere, and just it was amazing. I've been part of the Durham Gala walk for it since inception, really. You get that from the Durham Gala, but what I also wanted to see and to bring really to bring to the table is sort of kind of passion, and I want to make this the best that I'll ever be.
And I've come today to find out what it's all about really, and to take it back so I can encourage my clients to attend these meetings and get involved in the work.
Hi, I'm Dot. I work for NECA in County Durham and I'm also a charity trustee, UKRW trustee. Obviously we've been to 3 of the UK recovery walks and seen what that creates within the host cities, and we really want that for Durham, and I just look forward to the actual day and the legacy it's going to leave behind.
Hello, I'm Hugh. I work for Adaction. I'm the Partnership Manager in Eden House Treatment Centre up in Consett. I've only been working in County Durham since July, and I've been knocked out by the strength of the recovery community in County Durham, and I want to support that. I feel I'm a friend of that, and I want to help everyone going forward. I was in Manchester, and I think what we saw was a recovery nation. I thought we saw recovery nation. I'm staggered, like you said, Murray, that it doesn't get the press and the column inches that it should, and I think that's down to us. I too am something of a musician. I don't think we're going to have any problem getting musicians together in County Durham, and like Lynn said, and I'm glad that Lynn said it and Mark said it, I wanted to be the best. If you can
hold on. For you in your mind, what would a really successful UK recovery walk in Durham look like? 45 minutes, record what you are saying, go for it.
Flashing lights, bright, lots of colour. Try involving the community in the planning. So rather than this is something happening to the community in a random day in September, they get involved throughout the year.
Make it look like a good celebration. Music, loud, very colourful. Market it properly, advertise properly, communication. Leaflets, relevant info, so everyone knows what it's all about and that.
Balloons, setting off balloons as well. You know, having recovery balloons, let them go.
Loving atmosphere and that, know what I mean? And health eating, not just the buggers, health eating as well, because when we noticed doing it, as what's been mentioned, there wasn't a lot of food vendors down there, know what I mean? But we could have a choice, know what I mean? We could have a different choice from different cultures.
Possibly putting a big art in, if somebody fits in with the arts and crafts, putting in a big art installation a couple of weeks beforehand to raise awareness, you know, somewhere in the market square.
And other like countries and stuff involved. Linking the international NA convention, all forms of fellowships be involved.
About badges, having blank badges there so people can put the name and if they're in recovery on a badge so that you know you can see, or if they're a family member or, you know, and it's something free to, for them to take.
Knights, bishops and that, know what I mean, going with the Durham theme and that, know what I mean, and might have a few ponies, but don't say a few ponies, people want ponies and that with the chargers.
Throw a sponge at the therapist, and it was his own idea, Dot, throw rotten tomatoes at the commissioner. I said something about...
I said
we wouldn't.
And I said they'd never get behind all the providers, there'll be no recovery community there.
I've input from people in the prisons from the northeast.
As well, looking at for the family side of it, because we're a mining village, little mining villages, have a brass band there for the miners, have people dressed up as miners there, have a stall there for the miners, because I know addiction's touched a lot of mining families, you know, so I think we need to tie that in. It fits well with it.
We spoke about sponsorship from local shops, sponsoring the walk now, and we could have volunteers of people on the walk with banners, with boots on it, Tesco's on it or something like that, know what I mean? And they're getting part of it as well. They've said, well, we've put something to that World Recovery community today, know what I mean?
Dances, having little dances there. There's loads of little dancing schools around County Durham with children. You know, the kids love it. There's any amount of kids there, adults there. Have little dancing stands there so the kids can enjoy it, the adults can enjoy it and things. And the remembrance side of it, you know, remembering the ones that we have lost, I think we need to look at a bigger way of, you know, showing that we do care, that it is serious as well, that it is a life and death thing, and, you know, have something more passionate, more bigger to remember them that we have lost.
Remember, we wanted before walking down, we wanted people to see the cathedral and see the castle and that and taking that atmosphere in, know what I mean? They're getting to see that. So these are memories that they won't forget. Times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. It's been talked about for so long, and to know to be doing it and putting the action in, it says a lot, which is great, and let's send on next month.
Very inspirational, and I've already got a little list of people I think that need to come along and that could add to the planning of it.
I was disappointed that we didn't get the walk last year. I am. But looking back, pleased, because, you know, we're a year down the road now. We've got a more mature recovery community. Some of the people that are here today wouldn't have been here then. So the skills and everything that we've got today, I think we're ideally placed to pull it off and pull it off with style and panache.
I enjoyed the walk last year, but if anything from in this room today is going to go by, this one's going to be the biggest and the best, so I just can't wait to see it.
If there's one thing County Durham is known for, we'll put my heart and soul into everything to do with the walk and we'll have a great day.
It's great to see all the goodwill and commitment around the room, the professionals and the recoverers coming together with a common objective.
Feeling positive, really, really positive about it, and I think it started, hasn't it? It's that feeling of, oh God, this is it. It's starting, that first foot forward, so there's no going back now. And I love it, I'm ready for it, raring to go.
I'm just glad to be here and I'm looking forward to it and I can't wait to be part of it.
I'm just proud to be a part of something instead of being far from it. So I'd be glad when I just be a part of it and give something back instead of taking all the time.